Hello everyone, now we'll be discussing about the base adsorption. So what is base adsorption? It is expressed as a number of grams of liquid base that is required to produce a capsulated mixture when mixed with 1 gram of solid or solids. And this base adsorption is influenced by various factors of solids, such as their particle size and shape, its physical state, that is whether the solid is fibrous, amorphous or crystalline, its density, the moisture content and the nature of the solid, that is whether it is lipophilic or hydrophilic. These are the factors that influence the base adsorption. Now, whenever we determine base adsorption, the complete wetting of solids is essential. And in case of glycols and non-ionic bases, the addition of wetting agent is not required to achieve the wetting of solids. But in case of vegetable oils, whenever vegetable oils are used, complete wetting of solids is not achieved without the addition of wetting agent. In such cases, whenever vegetable oils are used, soil lecithin at a concentration of 2-3% is employed as a wetting agent. Coming to the determination of base adsorption, in order to determine, first we have to weigh 40 grams of solid into a 150 ml tarred beaker, and in a separate beaker, 150 ml tarred beaker, place about 100 grams of liquid base. In one beaker we have to place 40 grams of solid, and in another beaker we have to place 100 grams of liquid base. After that, add small increments of base to the solid using a spatula, and using a spatula, stir the base uniformly into the solid after each addition, and this should produce a mixture with soft ointment like consistency. So after each addition, we have to stir using a spatula uniformly so that proper coating is achieved. After that, continue to add liquid and stir continuously until the mixture flows steadily. Previously we have got ointment like consistency. After that also we have to continuously add the liquid and stir rigorously until the mixture flows steadily from the spatula blade when held at 45 degree angle above the mixture. It should flow steadily from the spatula blade when held at 45 degree angle above the mixture, and the flow must be even and continuous, not in globes. And one more thing is, attention must be given to the nature of cutoff quantity of the mixture. So whenever a mixture stops flowing properly, when we have a proper cutoff, it is exhibited in such a way that the stream contracts rapidly upwards towards the spatula. So whenever the mixture stops flowing, if the stream contracts rapidly upwards towards the spatula blade, then it has got good cutoff point instead of stringing out into an intermediate flow. And care must be taken, or attention must be given to the nature of cutoff quantity of the mixture also while the determination of base adsorption. So finally, the formula is, base adsorption can be determined by the ratio of weight of base by weight of solid. Base adsorption is equal to weight of base by weight of solid. And lower the base adsorption of the solid, higher will be the density of the mixture and smaller will be the capsule size. As we all know, the production guideline is to select the smallest capsule size possible. So lower the base adsorption of the solid, higher will be the density and smaller will be the capsule size. And one more important point is, the base adsorption is not required for capsulation of drug. at a concentration 50 mg or less. Whenever any material or drug concentration is less than 50 mg, then the determination of base adsorption is not mandatory, because the smallest capsule size can accommodate that quantity of drug. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for further videos on GPAT.